After showers early this morning, it was a mostly cloudy day with moderate southeasterlies. After widespread 5 to 10 millimetres in the early hours of this morning, we only saw some light falls post 9 a.m, around 1 to 2 millimetres in most suburbs. Temperatures up to 9 degrees cooler than average, only reaching 17 in Terrey Hills, Penrith and Campbelltown, 18 in Kellyville, Liverpool and the city, but it fell close to around 14 degrees for most of the day, thanks to the wind chill. We've seen rain across the state, the heaviest falls around the Hunter, the Northern Tablelands, temperatures well below average, only reaching 17 degrees in Batemans Bay and Mudgee. Tomorrow, a deep low will send a trough over western Victoria and inland New South Wales with widespread gusty winds, showers and storms. Brisbane could see a possible shower. 25 degrees, cloudy in Canberra and a shower or two in Melbourne, 23 degrees. More rain is expected across the state tomorrow. The heaviest falls around the mid-north coast, the Hunter and the southwest slopes. Warming up a little along the coast, tops of 19 to 23 degrees, while inland areas will generally be cooler. This is how Sydney will look tomorrow. Partly cloudy, just a slight chance of a shower in the afternoon and early evening. If it arrives, it will bring up to a millimetre of rain and we'll see light to moderate northeasterly winds. Heading for a top of 19 degrees in Terrey Hills and Cronulla, 20 in Richmond, Blacktown and Parramatta, 21 in Penrith, Campbelltown and the city. Looking ahead, Thursday will be partly cloudy, 24 degrees. A shower or two on Friday, bringing between 1 to 10 millimetres of rain. Finding up again on Saturday, 27 degrees, with just a possible late shower on Sunday and into Monday, but it will be mostly fine. Those overnight lows range from 13 to 16 degrees. In our west, a possible shower on Thursday, 28, staying warm with a shower or two on Friday. The weekend looking fantastic, sunny and 27, 23 and 25 next week, so a little bit cooler. Those overnight lows ranging from 10 to 17 degrees, but it is slowly starting to warm back up, Georgie.
Hello again. We had a lovely start to the day from a low of 10 just after 4:30 a.m. Under blue skies and light winds, we had a maximum of 27 just before 4 p.m. That's around 7 degrees above average. For the suburbs, it was mild overnight, but then our spring sunshine pushed maximums to the mid-20s through the north. Epping and Tullamarine reached 27. They were the warmest. Across Victoria, it was warmest through the northeast, with Rutherglen getting to 27. We can see lines of showers that have moved across the state. They're stretching from the north right down to the south. So far, falls have been light, but there is the possibility of storms sparking up, and there's currently a strong wind warning for the Gippsland Lakes, Central Coast and East Gippsland Coast. We can see a lot of lightning strikes on the satellite picture, and for Victoria, storms are most likely over northern and western areas. Yesterday, Sydney was smashed by storms. Today was calmer but gloomy. Tomorrow, a partly cloudy top of 21. Brisbane, 26 with late showers. Canberra, a cloudy 19. Hobart, 21 with afternoon showers. Adelaide, 29. And heating up through central Australia, 39 for Alice Springs. Tomorrow into the 30s through the Mallee, the low to mid-20s for southern areas, 21 degrees at Wodonga. Showers are expected through these areas and storms are possible across most of the state. Tonight, showers through the night. They will linger through the morning and pick up again in the afternoon. 19 degrees at Ferny Creek, the low to mid-20s elsewhere. For Geelong, a low of 14 with early showers, a top of 25 with fresh winds. Tomorrow in the city, light showers through the morning and a low of 15. Then a partly cloudy but windy top of 23 with the chance of a storm. Thursday, showers from the late afternoon and 26 degrees. Friday is the problematic day. A showery morning will become a rainy afternoon with gusty showers and the chance of storms, 25 degrees. Saturday, windy for most of the day, 18 degrees with light showers. A shower or two on Sunday, 18 again. 21 on Monday and 27 on Tuesday under warm northerlies. Overnight showers will linger through tomorrow morning, a low of 15 and a windy top of 23 with showers redeveloped developing through the afternoon. Tonight's showers should start around 9 or 10
p.m. Right, at the moment, lofty rain and storms are hitting Redcliffe, Bribie Island, extending northwest through Woodford and up around Kilcoyne. It has cleared Brisbane and here on the Gold Coast, but some heavier rain here. here this afternoon. Let's go to the radar starting just after midday. And there were widespread falls of 20 to 40 millimetres. You can see the storms. Then that line of storms extending right up through to around Ipswich, hitting Brisbane after 5 o'clock this afternoon. So some good falls of rain in quite a short period of time, but it will clear offshore over the next hour or two. Let's have a look at temperatures across southeast Queensland today. A little bit warmer right across all the suburbs today than the past few days. 26 on the Goldie, Redcliffe, Sunshine Coast, 27 in Logan, Caboolture, Brisbane, 28 Greenbank, Archerfield and Bow Desert, 29 the high in Ipswich and Gatton. The weather map, unstable air in the east will generate showers and storms across New South Wales, Victoria and southern Queensland, while a cold front will deliver showers and storms with gusty winds for southern WA. Interstate showers in Perth, sunny for Adelaide, shower or two Melbourne, Canberra and also in Sydney, 39 degrees for Alice Springs, a shower or two in Darwin tomorrow. Queensland, partly cloudy and low 30s for Cairns, Townsville, 28 Mackay, 29 Rocky, Gladstone 27 degrees tomorrow, mostly sunny and high 20s around Bundaberg, Maryborough and Gympie, hot and dry inland 38 for Mount Isa and 37 in Longreach. Southeast Queensland, partly cloudy, there's still the chance of a shower anytime from late morning, not really expecting those thunderstorms tomorrow, while daytime temperatures in the mid to high 20s. Moreton Bay, light and variable winds, tending northeast 10 to 15 knots. Brisbane, partly cloudy, chance of a shower, a high of 25 degrees. Your 7-day outlook, Thursday partly cloudy in 29, fine Friday in 29, an evening shower Saturday with 33 degrees and a possible thunderstorm, a warm one on Sunday as well. But it'll be fine on Friday for the NRL Pacific Championships at Suncorp Stadium. We've got two double passes to give away. Come on down, we'll do the draw shortly at Southport Surf Lifesaving Club, guys.
Hello again. Well, it's been a funny old day. It's definitely been keeping us on our toes. Just in the past probably 15 to 20 minutes or so, the winds have started picking up here in the hills. We've seen some storms bubbling up kind of to the north of Adelaide through the Barossa and through the hills in the recent moments as well. So it's certainly been a day that's been full of surprises. Overnight we had the gusty conditions and of course today the very warm weather, our top of 31 degrees, which is about 10 degrees above average for this time of year. So it's all happening. I'll take you through it. Around the suburbs today, we certainly did see those warm temperatures. And for the most part through the metro area, it has been dry. 32 degrees was the top at Mawson Lakes today, 31 at Norlunga and Glenelg. There have been heaps of storms to the north of Adelaide, and the heaviest falls, are including overnight, has actually been through the hills, 26 millimetres near Mount Crawford. And another 10 millimetres in the Barossa tonight with those storms continuing. It's all been very hit and miss and the showers have been much more sparse through the south, only half a millimetre at Mount Gambier today. So taking a look at the charts here, it shapes up that tomorrow is kind of a break day with those storms for most of SA. There's still a slight chance and perhaps something bubbling up around the eastern border regions where that trough will be lingering. Interstate Melbourne could certainly see showers and storms tomorrow with a windy 23 degrees, so keep that in mind if you are travelling. But things are looking more settled in Sydney with a partly cloudy 21. Back to SA, and it sure is another hot day across much of our state tomorrow. Roxby Downs is expecting 39 degrees, Port Augusta 38 and Port Pirie 35. There's a slight chance of storms lingering through there, but not like today. Nuriutpa is looking warm with 29 degrees on the way, Murray Bridge 31 and Keith 30 degrees. On local waters tomorrow, east to northeasterlies below 10 knots, becoming south to southwesterly in the middle of the day. And it's another warm day around Adelaide tomorrow, 31 degrees in store for Elizabeth, 29 for Golden Grove and 28 at Marion. So once again, these temperatures are a good 8 to 10 degrees above average for this time of year. Now, no storms on the forecast for Adelaide tomorrow, but we do have that hot weather again back up in the high 20s there. Thursday is the day that we're probably a greater chance of seeing some more storms reinvigorating back on the forecast. And it's looking hot again on Thursday with a top of 30 degrees on the way. But then we are seeing things change on Friday. In fact, we're back down to the low 20s. Still a showery day, but looking much more settled over the weekend. 21 degrees on Saturday and 24 degrees on Sunday. So much more kind of usual temperatures for this time of year and a much more stable weekend in store.